Namaste. I am Munishwar Goswami. I am from Ghaziabad. I have studied of yoga for last 3 years. 1 year from Haridwar Gurukul Kangri University,
yeah.
And 2 year master degree from Sagar, Madhya Pradesh, from Guru Dr. Hari Singh Gaur University.
As far as yoga and health go, what is the exact link?
Health and yoga is health and yoga are the part of the main thing for life.
Yeah.
So they both are depend on each other.
Yeah.
No, according yoga, there is no health, and without health, for health you need happiness, and without happiness you cannot get health, and happiness will only come through the yoga.
So what are the kind of illnesses that you feel yoga would be particularly good at treating?
Especially the nowadays the illness, the disease are come from your mind, from mental disease. So it's all cure from through the yoga. And actually the yoga is not the main purpose of yoga is not improve your health. It's maintain your health. It's not only for disease. It's
okay.
Make you happy and healthy.
To keep you keep your body
keep
in
your
a state
body.
Of health.
Yes.
Right. Yeah.
Now I'm going to start through Noli, the exercise for your stomach. It's give a massage to your intestines, to your digestion system. It's very good for diabetes and any kind of digestion problem you can remove through that.
Yeah.
That's called the Madhyam Noli.
It's basically breathing based and control of the stomach muscles, or?
Breathing based and control on your muscles.
But it's quite complex, not anyone would be able to do it.
And now I will give a movement to this one, give a massage to my intestines. It was the collection of intestine in between of your stomach. Now I will give a movement to them.
Oh wow, that's quite something. Thanks.
There are some asanas, the easy asanas, so everyone can do this, and these are more beneficial. This is the Vajrasana. This is very good for digestion system. Because of in this asana, the circulation of blood in your leg will be stopped, and the blood of legs will come into your stomach. So and because of gravity, the upper body blood will also come down into your stomach. So it is very good for digestion system. And this is only one pose which we can do after the food also. There is no other exercise which we can do after food, only this one, this pose. The second one.
So it's basically just sitting, it involves
just sitting
in a proper position.
The sitting in proper position. Second one for diabetes and for obesity. And for main, nowadays the problem is backache is major problem in the society. So forward bending and backward bending are beneficial for this process. Breathe in, out, bend as much as possible for you. The final pose is this. If you can do like this, it's okay. Just try.
Yeah.
Then from other side.
Everyone may not have as flexible a body as...
No, so you can do practice like this, only this much also okay. Because it's give a forward bend to your back, from your neck to your root. And nowadays the problem, we are generally we are doing the office job on the chair.
Yeah.
So there is major problem of cervical spondylitis. for that one. Just stand up on your knees. It's very easy. Keep your hand on your back. Breathe in and give a bend to your back. As much as possible. This much, this much, this much, this much.
Oh wow.
That's very good for cervical also and every type of back ache, because in daily life we never do the backward bending. Even we riding, walking, also we bending to forward. Even generally we sitting in conference anywhere, we bend, we use forward bending more. So our back get spoiled through this one. So we need the backward bending also.
Thank
this
you.
This type of backward bending is helpful for any type of back ache.
Thank you so much.